Welcome to Thursday Geeks of the Week, where every week is Geek Week, except for the upcoming B Week. Look for that. Super soon. Bees. Geeks of the Week. Steph, my superpowers are hats, which raises the question, why hasn't there been a comic about a magical hat that gives the wearer superpowers? You should totally get on that. Wait, doesn't that sound like the premise for Frosty the Snowman? You did ask us how do we feel about geeky things becoming more mainstream, and I'm pretty sure somebody else already asked this, but my feelings haven't changed since then. I think it's a good thing geek things have become more popular. It's always awesome to have these new people trying to be interested in these things that we love. As Nuko mentioned, there is some concern. As it gets bigger, it might be interpreted the wrong way, and that's the risk it runs. Still, I feel it's been a positive thing that geek culture has become more mainstream. Pyro, I really like the goofy hat you have in the back, and one day we're going to have a hat off. As for finding me, you never will, because I am a master of disguise. I'm a pole. Look at me, I'm a pole. I'm a fantastic pole. Here's a new fact I learned. A grumpy little girl punes a grumpy cat, and I really love the opinion you had on the New York Times article, The Heroes for Cosplay, and how you answered Seth's question. You brought up a lot of valid points, and that's why you're my rock star, dude. Nikki, now that you revealed your guys' massive plan, let me give you some tips on how to make me cry. Tears of laughter. When I laugh uncontrollably, I've been known to shed a tear or two. For example, that video on your personal channel of you wishing Harry Potter a happy birthday, I cried a little. They want sad emotional tears? Why? Ah, they taste the sweetest. You guys have no idea how much I miss Game of Thrones. My every other thought becomes occupied with thoughts of it. Like, should I grow a beard to look like Robb Stark? I'm gonna call that girl the C word. You are being such a Cersei Lannister right now. Hold on. So if you're like me, here's some awesome Game of Thrones videos to hold you over until it's back. As always, all the links provided below. At Comic-Con, they debuted this great Game of Thrones in memoriam video to the music of what else but Boys to Men, It's So Hard to Say Goodbye. At the beginning, I laughed, and towards the end, I got a little choked up. I must warn you for spoilers, do not watch this video unless you've seen the past two seasons, because it does contain all the deaths. You know who I hate? Jimmy Fallon. He knows why. You know who's growing on me? Jimmy Fallon. He did this great Game of Thrones parody titled Game of Deaths. Check the link below. In something I saw from Nikki, a while back she posted a video on our Facebook page from Stage 5 TV, a Game of Thrones style song titled We Are the North, Hold On Remix. Since there was a remix, I got me thinking there has to be an original. So check out this video and something I will want for my birthday, Game of Thrones Ultimate Birthday Rap Battle. Finally, Maisie Williams, who's the actress who plays Arya Stark, is cooler than we ever were at her age. She's cooler than us right now. You want proof? She posts these great funny videos on Vine. I'll give you a link to her Twitter where you can find them. Seriously, you need to check them out and revel in the awesome that is she. Also, Valma Lewis. No? Damn. Seriously, what am I going to do about Game of Thrones? What? Breaking Bad's back this weekend? Oh, okay. I'll be fine. Woo! I think it's that time for comic reviews from me, the best comic reviewer in the world. Yes! I'm going to start off with All New X-Men issue 15, written by Brian Michael Bendis and not by David LaFuente. And the original X-Men class are still in the present, and in this issue, a young Scott and Bobby go out for some afternoon teen shenanigans, while Jean discovers the feelings a young Hank has for her. Seriously, does everybody fall in love with Jean Grey? The answer to that is absolutely what's not to love. Imagine you get a box that says brownies. You're expecting a delicious treat inside, so you open it and there's poop. Your reaction is, what the fuck? That's what this comic has become. Seriously, they need to go somewhere with the original X-Men class being in this time period. The story is starting to drag. David LaFuente was a fill-in artist, and the artwork was sloppy. Stuart and Manin is sorely missed. There's no reason to pick up this issue, and I rate it 2.5 out of 5. Next, Sidekick issue 1, written by J. Michael Straczynski and not by Tom Mandrake. This is about a grown-up sidekick by the name of Flyboy, whose life has hit the skids ever since his partner, the Red Cow, gets assassinated. By the way, this is Steph's recommendation for the week, so I'm calling it Steph's Pick. And right now, I wish I was really good at graphics because that has Steph's derpy face as a logo somewhere in this part of the video. This comic was depressing to read, and I mean that in a good way. Flyboy's life becomes so low and pathetic, it literally becomes hard to watch. Suzuki pulls no punches, it's a gritty story, and no spoilers, but it does end with a mystery to solve. This is a solid start to a new series, and I rate it 4.5 out of 5. Next, Green Arrow issue 23, written by Jeff Lemire and art by Andrea Sorrentino. And this is the conclusion of a short arc as Green Arrow is in Latva trying to get out the former deadly assassin known as the Dragon because she has some information about his pappy. Ever since Jeff Lemire took over this title, it's become excellent. Great action, interesting story as we discover more about Ollie. I have said this before, I do miss older goatee Ollie, but this new young Green Arrow is growing on me. And the artwork is fantastic. It's one of the best drawn books out there. This is one of DC's best titles right now, and I rate this 4.5 out of 5. And finally, The Superior Foes of Spider-Man Issue 2, written by Nick Spencer and art by Steve Lieber. And this comic focuses on the new Secret Six that only has 5 members and is led by Boomerang, who's out on bail and has the Chameleon breathing down his neck because he owes him something. The debut of this series made my top 5 last month. Did the second live up to the first, or was it a one-hit wonder? Okay, let's get this out of the way. It did live up to it. I don't want to be premature, but if this title continues going the way it is, this is going to be one of Marvel's best comics out there. It's sharp, it's funny. Even if you don't know any of these Spider-Man villains, it's incredibly easy to follow. The artwork is just perfect for this type of comic. It has a very noir feel to it. I rate this issue 4.5 out of 5. Before I go, I want to say how sad I am to hear about the passing of Michael Eisner. He was the voice of Mr. Freeze in Batman the Animated Series. His voice was perfect for the role. There was a cold, sad feature to it. He will always be the definitive Mr. Freeze and will be missed. So that's it for me. Remember to subscribe to us. Follow me on Twitter. Check out our Facebook. Check out the other geeks this week and stay geeky.